In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can automate Twitter threads with AI by simply sending an email. Now, this process will work on X or Twitter, Threads, Blue Sky, and other relevant platforms. So be sure to stick around for the full video. And if this happens to be your first time to the channel, welcome. My name is Ryan, and I help business owners and creators leverage AI to scale content, save time, and ultimately make more money online. And if you want to know my favorite AI tools, prompts, and even some automation templates, be sure to get my free AI Marketing Essentials Guide. You can find the link for this in the video description or pinned comment below. So in this example, I'm using Make.com, but this scenario will also work on other no-code automation platforms like Zapier, N8N, Gumloop, etc. And I will be providing the template for this automation with Make.com in the video description below if you want to follow along. And speaking of templates, if you want some more advanced automation templates, such as this one, which automates my entire social media presence, be sure to sign up for my community. It's only a few bucks a month to join. That also helps support me and this channel. And I will leave a link to my community in the video description below as well. So first I'm going to run through this automation and show you what it does. And then after that, I'm going to go back and talk about each module step by step in this scenario. You'll notice here I'm starting with Gmail. Now you don't have to use Gmail, but since most people have Gmail, it's easy to set up and use. I figured this would be a good option. You can use Slack, for instance. You can use Telegram. You'll see what I mean here as I start explaining this and show you what this accomplishes. And so what I'm going to do first is pull up my Gmail. And so what I'm going to do is click compose, and I'm going to send myself an email. Think about how much easier this is on a mobile device if you're thinking of something or something's trending in the news and you want to go ahead and write an engaging thread about it. And so in this example, I'm actually going to send this email to myself. For the subject line, this is super important as that will trigger the automation. I'll show you the inside of that here shortly. So what we want to do for the subject line is type in the word thread. That will prompt the automation to run. And then I'm going to say GPT-5. Now, for the actual body here, you'll notice I have a voice dictation. This is actually a Chrome extension I installed. Maybe there's an easier way to use voice on Gmail, and I'm just too stupid to figure it out. But I would install some sort of Chrome extension if you want to actually talk to this versus type something out. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Hi, I need you to write a thread about GPT-5, its real-world use cases, and why it's important for marketers, creators, and business owners to start using GPT-5. All right, so maybe I need to go in here and edit a few things and whatnot, but this is just a really simple idea to show you how this automation is going to run. So I'm going to go ahead and click send, and you'll see here that this email did come through, so I know it went through correctly. And if we go back to this automation, I'm going to go ahead and click the Gmail module. I'm going to right click, choose where to start, select the first email, and then I'm going to go ahead and find that email. So here it is on August 19th. I'm going to click save. And then what I'm going to do is we're going to block off Twitter for now. I don't want to run this to a test. Since I only have about one Threads follower, I'll use that as the test run. And I do have a Google Docs module here for a lot of test outputs as well. But I'm going to go ahead and run this automation. I'm going to skip ahead when it's finished, and I'm going to show you what it produced. All right, so if I hop over to my Threads account, which I just set up yesterday, by the way, I'm using this for testing purposes, you'll notice here I do have a new post. That's the thread on GPT-5. And if I click this, you'll notice here it automatically created a thread. Here's the main post. GPT-5 is here. It's reshaping how marketers, creators, and business owners work. And here's how you can use it to stay ahead. Here's the first post in the thread. Real world use case 1, content creation. Real world use case 2, customer engagement. Use case 3, market research. Why creators should care. GPT-5, blah, blah, blah. Now, am I saying that I would actually post this exact thing on my Twitter account to the public with, you know, whatever 1300 or so followers that I have? Probably not. I would make sure that the inputs in that Gmail or that email within my Gmail account is as detailed as possible to produce the highest quality thread. And if I go to that test Google Doc where I like to test all my outputs, this is how I know it went through correctly. Again, I'd recommend just for running any automations that you always have a Google Docs or some Gmail module that you can just dump the test outputs to before we actually fully run things. So this did work correctly. That's the real world use case here. We're going from our Gmail account, telling it to write an engaging thread about a trending topic on whatever you want, and then automatically posting it to Twitter, to Threads, to Blue Sky, or whatever relevant social platform that you want. But now let's go back to this automation, and I'm going to show you each module step by step. So like I mentioned earlier, the very first module that triggers everything in this scenario is Gmail. So I'm going to go ahead and click into this Gmail module, and the first thing that you need to do is integrate your Gmail account by clicking add and then following the directions here. I'll be honest, this can be very confusing if this is your first time doing this. I'll leave a troubleshooting video in the description below if you get stuck here. And then for the folder, once you're signed in, I'd recommend just leaving it at sent mail. It's going to be easier to organize and manage. Leave Gmail filter. For the query, you'll see I have it as thread, which is what I typed in when I was running this automation to start. I would just leave it. You can name it whatever you want, but I would just leave it as thread. Leave maximum number of results as 1. Leave this as yes, and then go ahead and click save. Now, the next step in this automation, or the next module, I should say, is this OpenAI module. And if I click into this, the first thing that you need to do is establish your connection with an OpenAI account. So you'll click add, and then you'll need an API key. And if you don't have that, you'll want to visit platform.openai.com. Create a free account, and I'd recommend adding at least probably $5 to your balance. Doesn't have to be anything crazy. And then what you want to do is click API keys on the bottom left, click create new key, give it a name, and then click create secret key. And then you would copy and paste that over here where it says API key, and then you would click save. And then once you're integrated, just leave the method as is. For the model, I'm on GPT 4.1. You can go ahead and try a GPT 5 model if you prefer, like GPT 5 mini. But I've noticed that for a lot of these automations right now, there's a lot of like integration issues and whatnot. GPT 5 is still relatively a new model. So for this particular instance, I'd recommend just leaving it on like a GPT 4.1. And then over time, I'm going to start changing things to GPT 5. Now for the text and style, I would recommend just leaving this as is. You can definitely go in here and start changing some things, but make sure you do not change this JSON format down here, or you don't change this idea where it's pulling the text content in from that Gmail module, as you'll see right here where it says text content. So I'd recommend just leaving the rest of these as is. You can feel free to edit if you want. Just do not mess up this JSON format down here or this text content from the Gmail module. So I'm going to click save, and then I'm going to click save again. Now, the next module is extremely important, but I would recommend just leaving this as is. And this is the parse JSON module. And if I click into this, this is going to be parsing JSON from the previous OpenAI module. You'll see it says choices and then message content. So if I click into this, click choices dropdown, message, and then you'll see where it says content. That is where it's pulling the copy for that actual thread output. And if I open up the OpenAI module, I'm going to try to explain this as elementary as I possibly can. I'm not super technical myself, but on the text content, if I scroll down, you'll notice the output here is in a valid JSON format. First tweet, additional posts, third tweet, media URLs, etc. If I were doing just a single basic social media post on Twitter, Facebook, LinkedIn, etc., there would be no need for this JSON format and then needing to parse the JSON. So that's like my quick high level, the reason for that. It's because we're creating a thread post and not just a basic text post. So just leave this as is, and you shouldn't run into any issues. And if you do, just comment in this video below and I'll try to help you out. So you'll notice the next step in this automation is a router, and this simply routes the scenario into 3 additional modules. We have Twitter, Threads, and then also a Google Docs module. And I'll talk about the Google Docs module first. This is definitely the less important out of the 3 here. This is essentially for testing purposes. So all you need to do is integrate your Google account. And if you have this template, it'll be very easy to follow along. I know my camera is kind of covering the inputs right here, but all this Google Docs module is for, so I can test the outputs of the automation. You'll see here, these are the outputs that I originally showed you on my Threads account. So it also landed here. And I would recommend always having a test module like a Google Docs, a Gmail, or really anywhere that you can dump those test outputs before we just blast things off to our social media accounts and hope for the best. So that's the reason behind this Google Docs module. Now, if we look on top here, you'll notice this module says Twitter and Threads. But if you've never seen this icon before, you might be asking yourself, well, that's not Twitter or that's not Threads. And this is called Blotato. This is one of my favorite AI tools for marketing and content creation. And so in order to run this automation successfully, you do need to sign up for a paid Blotato plan. I would recommend doing that. It's only $29 a month. I'll leave this link and I'll also leave my review of Blotato in the video description below. And for $29 a month, you get unlimited access to social media APIs along with all of these additional features. And that might sound steep just to use for automations, but if we compare this with other AI tools that are charging thousands just for social media APIs, not going to say any names, but I can leave a review to them in my description below as well. And if you think about other social media management platforms, Hootsuite, Sprout Social, Buffer, et cetera, they're all charging hundreds of dollars a month for social media management with less features. So I am so bullish on what Sabrina Romanoff and her team is building with Blotato to help us automate social media and other forms of content creation. So I would highly recommend signing up for this tool if you're serious about scaling your social media accounts. So once you sign up for Blotato, again, you do need that $29 a month plan to use the APIs. Once you're logged into the dashboard, click the settings icon, click API, and then you should get an API key here. So go ahead and click copy that. Come back to our make.com automation. So you'll need to add this for the first time since obviously, you know, this will be in my account if you're using the template. So go ahead and click add, paste that API key right here, and then you would click save. And then once your account is established, what we need to do is go back to Blotato, click accounts, and then we need to integrate our social media accounts within the Blotato platform. You'll see I've done this for Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, LinkedIn, Threads, TikTok, and Twitter or X. You can also do this with Blue Sky, Pinterest, or whatever your relevant platforms are. And so once you've integrated your social accounts on the back end of Blotato, come back to make.com, click your platform. So right here, it's Twitter. Find your Twitter account in the dropdown. So there it is right there. And then the rest of this, you should be able to leave as is. We want the additional posts created from that JSON module. We want text from the JSON module. And then we also want the media URLs from that JSON module. Then I'm going to click save. Now you'll notice here I have threads. So if you want Blue Sky, for instance, all you need to do is right click, click clone, and then you would add this to the router so you can unlink this, add it to the router, and then simply come in here and change the platform to Blue Sky, for instance, and then find your account in the dropdown. Now, I don't have a Blue Sky account within Blotato, but if you do, it'll happen right here. So I'm going to X out of that, delete the module, and then you'll see I have a Threads module, exact same setup as the Twitter module from before. I just had to change the platform to Threads, find my Threads account, and leave everything else as is, click save. I'm going to click save again, and now let's run this automation. So I'm back on my Gmail account, and I'm going to send myself another email here with that keyword thread in the subject lines, and I'm going to do a thread on the best AI tools this time. So I'm going to go ahead and click this voice option here. Write a thread about the best AI tools for marketing and content creation. I want you to include ChatGPT Plus, Claude, Gemini, Perplexity, Opus Clip, Blaze AI, and Blotato. All right, so you might need to go back and edit some things because obviously it's not going to spell everything correctly with some of these funky names. So I think this should all be good for the most part. So I'm going to go ahead and click send, and then that email did go through. Here's the email right here. So I'm going to go back to my make.com automation, right click, choose where to start, click select first email, and I'm going to find that latest email, which is right here. Click save. And then what I want to do is actually enable this route. I'm going to post it officially on my Twitter or X account just to see if it runs through correctly. So I'm going to click run once and I'm going to skip ahead and wait till this is complete. All right, so I'm actually going to delete this soon on my account, but I wanted to show you that this did go through correctly. Looking to upgrade your marketing and content creation workflow, here's a trend on the top AI tools: ChatGPT Plus, Claude, Gemini, Perplexity, Opus Clip, Blaze, Blotato, and then a call to action right here. So I'm going to go ahead and delete that here shortly, but I just wanted to show you that this did work from a simple 1 to 2 sentence email that I said, create a thread on the best AI tools for marketing and content creation. So that literally just works seamlessly. And if we go to our Threads account here, let's just double check that it posted correctly on my Threads. So if I go to my profile, you'll see right here, looking to upgrade your marketing and content creation workflow. So what I've noticed about Threads is this does take a little time for these to fully populate versus Twitter, it's instant. And then if I go to that Google Doc right here, click on my folder, let's refresh it. And then it should have went ahead and created a new document. There is the output of that thread right there. So I know that this worked correctly. So that essentially is how you automate Twitter threads that can also be applied to not only X or Twitter, but also Threads and Blue Sky with AI from a simple email. And I hope you found this tutorial valuable. And if you did, be sure to give me a thumbs up, subscribe to the channel. Also, let me know your thoughts in the comments below if this was a successful or valuable type of automation for you. I want to hear your thoughts on, you know, what are some other automations that you guys want me to cover? Also, be sure to look at my community for more advanced automations, like fully automating your social media content and several others that I have in here. But most importantly, I hope you all have a great day.